Hello, this is Steve Silva, and today I'd like to cover how Signal Integrity Toolbox can be used for regression analysis when used with SerDes Toolbox. So let's begin. So I initially built a transmitter and receiver SerDes model using SerDes Toolbox. And I did that initially. And then what I did is I then turned it into a Simulink model. And finally, I went and I opened up the AMI manager and I created a transmitter and receiver. So those have already been built. I have those now. So at this point, what I'd like to do is I want to take those models and put them into Signal Integrity Toolbox for regression. So what's cool is in this configuration block where you opened up the block to then go into the IBIS-AMI manager, you notice over on the right, there's another button there that's open signal integrity link. And so by pushing that, it now opens up another window, which enables you to be able to move the models that you just created over into Signal Integrity Toolbox. So here, I'm going to create a new serial link project. I'm going to title it something. I'll just call it SS. It's an NRZ model that I created. And I'll just call it NRZ1. Okay, I'm going to store it in my projects area. And what I'm going to do is now click on this button, which is create serial link project. Click on that. And what it did is it actually told me all the different things that it had that were already set in those models. And I don't know if you noticed, but in the background, it kicked off Signal Integrity Toolbox. So it started it. It built up a basic topology with some transmission line in the middle. And now what it's doing is actually going in and it's importing the transmitter and receiver that I just created. So you may not have noticed before, but basically these are the transmitter and receiver that I had created. I'm going to close this. And so if you haven't used Signal Integrity Toolbox, well, this is it. It has a area for schematic to build up a topology. Over on the left are various elements that you could use to build a topology. This would be more if you're trying to build up a specific channel. But in our application, what I want to do is basically test out those models. I want to run some regression analysis. I want to check out the different parameters that I created in those models and verify that those are creating the type of results that I expect. And then if you look down below here, this is actually the solution space. So what this is it has all the different controls that I created in my model. So in this particular case, I had an FFE and it's showing the different taps there. There's also in the receiver, I had a CTLE, DFE, CDR. So just by clicking on those, it shows me what those different options. So let's, for instance, look at the receiver. And over here on the CTLE, there are some different modes here. So let's say, for instance, that I would like to test out the various CTLE settings to verify that they are giving the type of outputs that I would expect. So there is, in this particular case, is a mode, and which is set to, it has options of being adapt, off, or fixed. So I'm going to set it to fixed because what I want to do is I want to basically check out all the different settings. And so there happen to be 9 settings. And if I do a right mouse, it'll actually allow me to set all the values. And what you'll see is it actually populates all the different values. So each column is now a separate simulation. So I am going to basically run all those different settings of the CTLE. Now, I do have a DFE here. And so if you look at the mode here, it's set to adapt. So in this particular case, may make more sense to turn that off because I don't want the DFE to be adapting to different values to adapt based on the different CTLE cases. I want to see each CTLE independently without the effect of the DFE. So I'm turning that off. So now I've got 9 values here. I can now actually go in and tell it to simulate. So if you look up above here, this little waveform is the simulate button. There are other ways to get to that as well, including the run button here. But right now I'm going to just go and hit that simulate button. I'm going to save changes. And there's a number of different options here, but what I'm going to do is just do statistical analysis because that is relatively fast. I could also do statistical and time domain, but right now I'm just going to do statistical again for the sake of time. Another thing that I should point out is that I can run these simulations in parallel based on the number of cores that I have. In this particular laptop that I'm using, I just have 4 cores, so it's going to run 4 simulations in parallel. However, you know, if you were using this on, you know, if you had more cores in your machine, if you had a server that had a lot, or let's say you had a server farm, you could have hundreds, thousands even, that you could run in parallel. That's very, very useful when it comes to regression because you can easily run into some pretty high numbers. So what I'm going to do is just tell this to run. It's initializing, and what it's going to do is basically go and run these simulations. Again, as I had indicated, it's going to run that the 4 of them in parallel, so it will not take that long for this to complete. So the other thing I should mention is I just have 1 stage of CTLE, so this is fairly easy. It's just 0 through 8, so it's 9 different settings that I'm working on, so that's fairly easy. You may have multiple stages. And if you have multiple stages, obviously, if you look at all the permutations, you could easily run into hundreds or even thousands of simulations. This can handle all of that, this product. And it's again, this is a really good way to be able to check out all the different settings on your model and make sure that it's producing the kind of results that you expected. So it's complete now, and what you can see down below, each row is a separate simulation. So if I wanted to, I could actually, you know, scroll over, look at maybe, here's eye height. If I click on it, I can look at the, it'll actually order this by the maximum eye height. And then if I select that particular one, tell it to show. I'll show bit error rate, which also includes the bathtub curves, but I could also show the statistical eye. And so here I can see, you know, okay, that's the eye that I got. It was open. Great. But let's say in this particular case, there are other ways to be able to look at the data. Let's say that you've got, you know, 30 or 100 or more of these different cases, and you want to be able to have a way to look at all of them. So you can put all these on top of each other. That's one way. But we also have a way of plotting the metrics. And you saw that we we plot a lot of different metrics. In fact, I can just show results here. There, we have all sorts of metrics here. We're going to show you the eye height, eye width, eye area. We're going to show you all the different conditions. It's going to show you, for instance, if you left the DFE in ADAPT, it's going to show you what those tap weights were. If you left the CTLE in ADAPT, it'll show you what that best CTLE curve that it selected to be able to do that. So what's nice is you have access to all these metrics, and you can actually take advantage of them in when you're using plots. So with plots is a way that you can actually create some scatter plots of all the different data that you have. So in this particular case, as I said, we've got 9 different simulations. I'm going to select them all. Actually, I'm going to go over here. You see that right here, I'm looking at PDA. In this particular case, I actually want to look at the statistical results. So I just selected that particular tab. Now let me go and select all the cases. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to, I want to plot eye height versus eye width. So if I go to this little gear here and click on that, it allows me to determine what the x-axis is going to be. So if I open that up and scroll through, what I could do is go and say, all right, I want to look at the eye width on the x-axis. So I have that. And now over here, this is my y-axis. So again, I can go through here and say, okay, where is my eye height? I'm going to select that, and I am going to add that. And so what you can see is that it's plotted on the eye height on the y-axis, eye width on the x-axis, and you can see the different, what the results were for each of the different CTLE curves. So this is a nice way to visualize your data and be able to get a good feel for things. And you may say, I'm not sure that that's what I expected. So you can go and click on one of these buttons and say, oh, let's look at this particular case. This case, again, is not exactly what I was expecting to see, or maybe it was this guy up here, which is 9. And then what I can do is look and say, okay, well, 9 is this TTE8. That's the label for that particular simulation. And now what I'd like to do is be able to take that simulation back into Simulink for debug, because I'm questioning whether this is giving me the right results. I don't know if that's the case or not, but I'm just saying, as an example, let's say that you were questioning this particular case. So now what I can do is I can actually go back to Signal Integrity Link, and what I can tell it to do is let's go and refresh the data that I ran. And what you can see is what it did is it gave me, it refreshed this data, and now I have all these different simulations to be able to choose from. And the one that I saw that I was questioning is this one, this TTTE-8. So I can select that, and now I can import that directly back into Simulink. And this will just take a few seconds. And again, what it did, you didn't see it because I put it on the other screen, it gave me all the settings that I had for that. And you can see it's CTLE config select number 8, so that which matches what I had just done. And now let's go back to Simulink. Simulink is here. And what's interesting is that the test case that I brought back is we did a lot of work to ensure that everything that is moved between these two products is exactly the same. So for instance, the channel, if I go and open up the channel, and if you look at the channel model, what is selected is impulse response. So this is from, it's named signal integrity impulse. So this is an impulse response from signal integrity toolbox. It could have been a loss model or whatever, but what had happened is it actually pushed this back into Simulink. So you didn't have to do this manually. Likewise, if you look at the stimulus, same deal. Signal integrity stimulus. This is a custom stimulus. It's exactly the same as what was in signal integrity toolbox. And so you'll be able to now again have this exactly replicated. Everything starts exactly in the same spot. There was a lot of effort put in to ensure that you would get the same results in both. We can run things here as an example. It'll then come up again with the same results. Here you are seeing that the eye diagram. And when this completes, it's going to show you what the statistical eye is and the time domain eye. And there they are with all the metrics. Okay, but the beauty here is that you would be able to, for instance, go into the source code, single step, set breakpoints, etc. You also, for instance, could go into here and put a scope maybe between the CTLE and the DFE. That's something obviously you can't do when you're in an EDA tool that has a IBIS-AMI model, because you can't see inside the model, or you can't see between these blocks. But since you created this model and you have the source code, we are able to do it when you're in Simulink. So this is some of the things I wanted you to see. It's quite powerful to be able to utilize a signal integrity toolbox when you're using SerDes toolbox, particularly for regression. I hope this was helpful. Thank you.